Hi, my name is Caitlin Maniatis, and I'm a registered dietitian here at Sunnybrook. Over the next few minutes, we'll be discussing methods of insertion, benefits, care, and feeding of gastrostomy or G-tubes. The gastrostomy, or G-tube, is a feeding tube that goes through the skin and abdominal wall and allows liquid, nutrition, and medications to be administered directly into the stomach. G-tubes provide a route to deliver nutrition and medication to those who are having difficulty swallowing or cannot take enough food by mouth. G-tubes help prevent weight loss, maintain nutritional status, and minimize risk of aspiration. Individuals with cancer, ALS, or those who have had a stroke or trauma often require G-tubes. Oral intake is encouraged even after G-tube insertion. G-tubes can provide liquid nutrition formulas as either a sole source of nutrition or to supplement oral intake. G-tubes may be placed by gastroenterology or interventional radiology. Gastroenterology will insert a percutaneous endoscopic gastrostomy tube or a PEG tube using an endoscope which travels through the mouth, down the esophagus, and into the stomach to guide tube insertion. Interventional radiology will use X-ray technology to aid in the insertion of the tubes. G-tubes can be inserted on an inpatient or outpatient basis. Before your G-tube is inserted, you'll be advised not to have anything to eat from midnight before the night of the procedure. Following tube insertion, you'll be instructed to either drink clear fluids, such as water or apple juice, or be provided with IV fluids to maintain hydration. Following an abdominal examination by your physician, you will be able to begin using the G-tube and resume oral intake of regular solid foods, if appropriate. If swallowing function improves or risk of aspiration is minimized, transitions can be made back to oral intake. Tubes can be removed, and the removal procedure will vary depending on the method of insertion. Clean the skin under the tab and around the tube every day with a Q-tip dipped in normal saline. Imagine the Q-tip is an arm on a clock and clean in a clockwise manner around the tube. When you're in the shower, clean the skin around the tube with a mild soap and water and ensure that you're drying the area completely when you're done. Do not take baths, and gauze dressing is not necessary unless you are having drainage from that tube site. Clean the tube and stoma site daily. Wash your hands thoroughly before completing any tube checks, and ensure that you're gently lifting the sides of the tube to examine the skin around the area. Signs of infection include fever, redness, tenderness, and any discharge that may be discolored or foul smelling. Secure the free end of the tube with tape on the abdomen or with a stretch gauze band. Check to see if the mark on your skin is at the same point as it was when it was initially placed. Do not pull on the tube because it can dislodge. There are two methods that can be utilized when feeding through the G-tube: syringe feeding and feeding by gravity. Remember to sit in an upright position during feeding and for 30 to 45 minutes after feeding to prevent regurgitation. The first step would be to wash your hands thoroughly. Next, fill the syringe with 60 milliliters of lukewarm water. Strain out the feeding tube and check tube placement. The mark on the tube should be the same place as when it was placed initially. Hold the tube above stomach height or pinch the tube and open the stopper or tube tip. Place the tip of the syringe into the end of your feeding tube and plunge the water through the tube. Cap the tube tip. Now you're ready to set up your feeding set. The first step is to shake the formula well. Make sure you wipe off the top of the formula can with a clean, damp paper towel, and don't forget to check the can for the expiration date. Close the roller clamp, so this means you'll be rolling the clamp down on the feeding set. Pour the desired amount of formula into the bag and hang it above head level. Remove the plastic cover from the tip of the feeding set and insert the tip of the feeding set into your feeding tube. Open the roller clamp, so roll it up, to start the feeding. You can adjust the rate that the feed runs through by opening and closing the roller clamp. So just simply roll it up or down to slow down or speed up the rate. At the end of feeding, close the roller clamp and disconnect the feeding set from the feeding tube. Finally, flush your tube with 60 milliliters of lukewarm water and close the feeding tube. You would follow the same steps to flush your tube with water as you would if you were using a gravity feeding set. The next step would be to fill the syringe with formula, the same way in which you would with water. Open the tube tip and place the tip of the syringe into the end of your feeding tube and slowly push the formula in. Refill the syringe until you've used the desired amount of feed. After feeding, run another 60 milliliters of lukewarm water through the tube to flush it clear. Hold the tip above stomach level or pinch the tube and disconnect the syringe from the tube. Close your feeding tube. Medications can be administered through the feeding tube, but just check with your pharmacist to ensure that your medications are crushable and don't require a liquid form, which may also be available. Ensure that you're flushing with water before and after medication administration, and do not mix the medications with the feeding formula. After feedings, clean the syringe parts with warm, soapy water and let them air dry. A bottle brush may be useful for cleaning these syringes. Once per day, soak the syringe parts as well as the feeding set in a mixture of 1/4 cup of vinegar and 1 cup of water for 5 minutes. Rinse with fresh water and ensure that you're allowing this fresh water to run through the tubing of the feeding set. Store the supplies in a container or Ziploc bag in the refrigerator to decrease the risk of bacterial growth. Do not put substances other than medications or tube feeding formulas through the tube as they may cause blockage. Sometimes medications and feeding formula can get stuck in the tube and cause blockage. And this is why you want to ensure that you're always flushing the tube before and after administration. If you do see that there is some buildup in your tube when you're flushing, try and apply a bit more force or pressure with that syringe that you're flushing through. If this doesn't relieve the blockage, then contact your healthcare professional. Do not pull on the tube because it can dislodge. If your tube does fall out, it needs to be replaced as soon as possible. Clean the area and cover with a sterile gauze pad and come to the hospital as soon as you can. Always sit upright in a chair or in bed when feeding. Cover your formula cans and store them in the refrigerator for up to 24 hours after they've been opened. If you have a feeling of uncomfortable fullness or bloating, slow down the rate of feeding. If you're using a feeding set, roll that roller clamp down to decrease the rate. And if you're syringe feeding, then slow down the force or the rate that you're pushing through the formula. For more information, speak with your registered dietitian or visit the clinical nutrition section of the Sunnybrook website.